Do I have everybody's attention now?
We're gonna have to do it again, Nintendo fanboys. We are going to have to do it again. Now, before I even make this video, I am not talking or speaking to the Nintendo fans, as in the normal people that are level-headed and actually have a head on their shoulders. I'm talking about the irrational, moronic, stupid, and apparently mentally deranged Nintendo fanboys. I'm not a politician, but if I was, today, tomorrow, in an hour, in a minute, I would pass a law immediately that enables the government to mentally screen individuals so they are enabled to play video games. And if you can't pass this mental test, then you are unfit as a human being, mentally and emotionally, to handle video games. Because that's what you Nintendo fanboys are. You are not healthy enough to handle video games and electronic entertainment. You aren't. Any comment or opinion expressed by me, another person, a media outlet, a video game website that isn't kissing Nintendo's butt or wiping their shoes or kissing their feet automatically is engaged with an unhealthy amount of hostility. It's true. You guys are worse than any fanboy group in the history of gaming. This includes the early factions of the Trey Brotherhood when I first came in here on YouTube. It's absolutely pathetic. You are the laughingstock of gaming. Plain and simple. The laughingstock of gaming. A bigger laughingstock than even the Sonic the Hedgehog fanboys. I mean, you guys talk about people like myself are destroying the gaming community or don't contribute to the gaming community. And yet, what exactly do you fanboys do? Because one, you don't make videos. Two, it's not like you're helping out any other gamers. I mean, you don't make tutorials. You're not like me. You're not helping people build PCs or helping people with components or explaining this or explaining that. The only thing you do is push your agenda upon other people. Because the fact of the matter is, you're not even real gamers. All you are a bunch of lonely people who want acceptance in a group of people. So you pledge loyalty to a logo and a corporation. I mean, if I were to tell you that you'd be buying a Wii U in March for a last generation port and a Lego game, you would have told me that I'm a moronic and idiotic hater. But that's exactly what you clowns have done. Xbox 360, by this time they had Ghost Recon Advanced Warfighter, Fight Night Round 3, Oblivion, next generation titles that by no means could have been done on the PlayStation 2, the Xbox, and the GameCube. What does the Wii U have right now? Exactly. The Wii U doesn't even have Nintendo games. And you all want to talk about how you buy Nintendo games, or I'm sorry, you buy Nintendo systems for Nintendo games, and yet you don't have any Nintendo games, do you? You take everything 100% to heart. Like everybody's out to get Nintendo, and that's not even the case. It's like I said before, you clowns are the biggest problem with Nintendo right now, because until you admit there is a problem, it's not going to be treated as if there is a problem. And people, there is a problem. Constant game delays, yet another game drought. It's like they have not learned their lesson since the N64. The hardware isn't anything special by any means, and neither is the online. Who is this console marketed to? It's not casuals, it's not core gamers, and it sure as hell is not Nintendo gamers like me who have been gaming with Nintendo consoles since the beginning. I mean, I've had people tell me just because I've owned and played Nintendo longer, doesn't mean I'm a bigger Nintendo fan. So just because I've owned regular Nintendo, Super Nintendo, N64, GameCube, Wii, Game Boy, Game Boy Pocket, Game Boy Color, Game Boy Advance, Nintendo DS, that means I'm not a Nintendo fan, because a real Nintendo fan is somebody, you know, that's just started gaming recently, that hasn't been around for the legacy of all these Nintendo franchises. Those are the real Nintendo fans. I mean, it makes my head hurt. Growing up, even the last couple generations, Nintendo has been top dog. But you people got to accept that other developers have caught up to Nintendo, just like other first-person shooter developers have caught up to Bungie and Halo. It's no different. I mean, you expect me to root for this team. This team that was once capturing titles, World Series, championships, Super Bowls, year in, year out, time after time after time. And I'm expected to happily cheer and be completely satisfied by that same team that can't even make the playoffs, that can't even win their division. That's a shell of their former self. Why? Why should I do that? Why should I accept mediocrity from a team, from a company, from a developer that was so good in the past but is so mediocre and average right now? Somebody tell me. Somebody tell me. And then you fanboys are so brainwashed. I really don't even understand it. I had a guy last night or a couple days ago and a bunch of other people say that physics, 1080p, 60 frames per second, higher fidelity graphics don't make it a definitive version of a game. Yet these are the same people that hype games like Need for Speed Underground 2 or Most Wanted 2 for the Wii U as the definitive version for those very same reasons. So what makes the game definitive? Lack of DLC? A sub-HD resolution? A horrible frame rate? Oh, I'm sorry, the damn tablet controller makes the game the definitive version of a game. Not the content in the game, but the controller. It's like unbelievable. It has been 15 months since Zelda Skyward Sword. 15 months since you got a top level A-tier class game from Nintendo. And don't give me Xenoblade, because Xenoblade was completed in 2010. It came out in Japan in 2010. Meaning, what the hell has Monolith Software been working on since 2010? Because we're in 2013 and all we've seen was one little damn trailer. How any of you fanboys can even call yourself Nintendo fans when this has been going on is beyond me. Now, I understand if you have a DS, because games like Fire Emblem Awakening and a lot of other franchises on the handhelds, they kick ass. But I'm not a handheld gamer. I like to game on home platforms. And when I'm looking at home platforms, I don't see anything on the Nintendo side. They pretty much left us high and dry the last 2 years of the system on the Wii, and the first year of the Wii has been pretty much a disaster. Which begins to ask the question, what exactly is the true life cycle of a Nintendo system? Because you don't get games in the first year, and pretty much you don't get games in the last 2 years, and this is dating back from the GameCube to the Wii to the N64. So the real life cycle of a Nintendo console is basically 3 years. As sad as that may seem, that is pretty much freaking true. Man. Sad. I mean, Nintendo used to be the man. Look at my back shelf. You will see all the games, all the classics from the original Mario, the original Metroid, the original Zelda. And look at Nintendo now, who's nothing compared to what they were. All they are is a bunch of mindless drones and corporate fanboys and cheerleaders parroting around, taking everything 100% personal, and literally making the company look worse than it already is. I got nothing else to say. Let's hope Nintendo picks the ball up, makes some announcements, comes out with some games, brings God knows what come E3, because the Xbox Durango and the PS4 are coming, people, and why they chose to launch the system a year early, if they didn't want to have any games for it, well, that's really beyond me. That's beyond me.
Black Bond, for example. Black Bond is your daddy.
It's that easy.